السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Whenever you are, wherever you are, this is our fourth story of Yaqeen. It happened end of 1999, the second Chechnya-Russia war between Chechnya, Ingushetia and North Ossetia. We decided that I go to Chechnya to make needs assessment. I want to take Muhammad, the representative of Islamic Leaf in Kabardino-Balkaria. He came to meet me in the airport, Moscow airport, in the international, then went from the international to the local airport. In the local airport, I look like a Muslim, I am dark skin, Muhammad is fair skin, both of us have beard. And the travel agent, the airline agent, when she looked at us and looked at the name, straight away she went and got the security officer. She was a very strong, very well built, tall, strong woman. And she was talking to her in Russian, trying to prevent us from going to this area of conflict, armed conflict. And the woman, the other Russian woman, which is the security officer, she looked at us, she looked at our name, and she asked us quite a few questions. And we have to be very transparent, very honest, and very trustworthy in our answer. And we said we are going there to help the people who are coming as a victim of war. That's it. Did not lie. Did not cheat. And the woman was convinced, because your honesty could save you million times. And she gave the airline officer or agent the tickets and the boarding and tell him, let them to board. She was talking to her in Russian. She said, let them to board. That's it. And alhamdulillah, Allah used this Russian security officer in our favor, because we had the yaqeen of being honest to be saved by Allah in front of everybody. We went, we boarded the airplane and we went to Nazran, the capital of Ingushetia. We were met by one of our colleagues working for Islamic Leaf to take us by the car to go inside Chechnya at that time. At that time, actually, Russia, at the time of Putin, at that time, trying to destroy the whole city of Grozny. And this was actually was done. By the time we arrived inside the city of Grozny, tried to meet some of the officials, the ministers, everybody left the city, and they went all to the mountain. And the city was deserted, only civilians were there. And we went to take some films in the hospital, in the streets, the destruction of the houses, and. You can't imagine what the Russians have done to the Chechen at that time by missiles, by airstrike, and by others, before the army entered there. We stayed about at least 2 nights there, and we came back on the morning of the third day. And while we were coming back, we found a long queue of military vehicles, armored military vehicles, and tanks getting inside Chechnya, with thousands and thousands and thousands of officers going with them. We stayed in Ingushetia to make needs assessment for the needs of the displaced people who came from Chechnya to Ingushetia. Then from there, we decided to go back to Kabardino-Balkaria. And we asked one of our volunteers in Nazran, in Ingushetia, to drive us by his car. He was the son of the Minister of Relief and Development in Ingushetia, Zakaria, Mr. Zakaria, and his son Muhammad put us in his car to go out. By the time we arrived to the border of between Ingushetia and North Ossetia, one of the police officers at the border looked at us. Three of us have beard, and he said one thing: you are Allahu Akbar Khattab. Said we are Allahu Akbar, because we are Muslims, but we don't know who was talking about it, Abu Khattab. He wanted some money from Muhammad, and Muhammad refused to give him money. Then he decided to take us to a military compound, and in the military compound we were locked in, and for hours. Then we told Muhammad Zakaria to go back to his to Ingushetia, and I told the other Muhammad to give him the films, because we had about 17 or 18 films with us, and we did not want the security to feel that we have been inside Chechnya at that time. He left us, and Muhammad said, okay, I'm going to give it to him. At the meantime, before Muhammad Zakaria left us, a Russian security military officer came and opened the boot of the car and or the trunk of the car and looked at the film, said, are these photographic films? Said, well, yes, they are. I said, keep them. I'll take them later on. Here, actually, something which Allah decided for us, because he knew that we are totally relying on him. He did not touch, the man did not touch these 17 films. Muhammad left, and I was under the impression that the other Muhammad has given him the 17 films. And we were waiting for the people to come and interrogate us for hours. At that time, we have one or two or three things to do. First of all, we used to read Ayat al-Kursi, قل هو الله أحد قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس and شاهد الوجوه الله أكبر شاهد الوجوه for the whole time. In this place you have nowhere actually to ask for help from anybody else. By the evening, which about 6 or 7 hours at that time, they called us for interrogation, and was about 4 or 5 people. All of them are Russian, and with a translator, and even the translator could not be able to speak proper English, to have that English Russian dictionary with him. And Muhammad was translating everything for me. And we're telling them the truth, that we came here to do A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and to help the people and so on. And when I found that the people actually were dealing with us in a civilian way, I started to have more confidence to be delivering a strong message to them by telling them, you people who traveled thousands and thousands and thousands of miles to come and help your people here, who have nothing to do with the war, who have nothing to do with the army, who have nothing to do with this. Said, we know that. But unfortunately, you broke our law by traveling with a visa which is restricted to Moscow area, and you traveled with it to any other area. I told them, whenever we go to the United States of America, which is as big as your country, the visa allows us to go to every state. But I said, we are not the United States. What we are going to do now is to charge you or to fine you with $200. So they are after the money, and we give them the $200, and we signed a document to say that they have charged that for coming to this area, and we left. Who was waiting for us outside? The same police officer who sent us to the military camp or the military compound. And he was negotiating with Muhammad for $50. Muhammad refused to give him anything. By the time we arrived, he was giving us a lift to go to the bus stop. By the time we arrived to the bus stop, actually, this man had a phone call from the one of the military officers asking him about the films with us. And they asked about the film with us. And they had two unused films in my pocket. I just gave it to them. Said, and he told the other officer on the other line, yes, we got the films from them. Then the man left, and we stood waiting for the bus. And the bus was so slow. The coach was slow, very slow coach. And I was talking to Muhammad, what did you, alhamdulillah, you have sent all the video and the films to give it to Zakaria. I said, no, all of them are with me. I was just furious, cursing, boiling, couldn't be able to do what was him. Because if those people with their mentality found that we have been to Grozny, they could have brought us somewhere else. Anyway, you have to wait for the bus to come, which was very slow coach, and you have to go separate, as we don't know one another. And we have to put the films underneath the seat. And the coach was so slow, or the minutes were so slow, or the seconds were so slow. Anyway, and midway through, the coach was stopped, or the bus was stopped, and a security officer came to the coach. And I was shocked, Muhammad was shocked, and we were trying to sink in our seats. But alhamdulillah, he looked at everybody and left us. This is the barakah of قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ and آيَةُ الْكُرْسِي and اللَّهُ أَكْبَرْ شَهَدْ الْوُجُوهُ and the barakah of al-yaqeen that you are there for Allah's cause to help the people of Allah, and he will never let you down. Then we arrived to the city, and we landed quite a distance from the house of Muhammad, and we took a taxi to take us to one or two street before the house, and if we are security agent, understanding what's going on, trying to be clever more than the people who are clever, more clever than us. Muhammad, let us to come by the taxi and one or two or three streets before your house, and to go there separately, and this kind of things which feeling come to you. Alhamdulillah, these 17 films which you took inside Grozny were with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the main tool after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of letting us spending at least $3 million before April 2000 on the same people. Our second journey in April to the same place were actually VIP reception by the local Minister of Foreign Affairs, aid and others, with the red carpet and the green carpet and the blue carpets for us. But yaqeen from Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِالْفَلَقِ قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةُ الْوُجُوهِ, can get you through a process of being protected, saved, guided and directed and controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله خير, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.